And here we are with a brand new section, and as you may have realized, this is one of those hands-on sections, as you're going to build yet another real-world program. And I use this particular program every single day for my personal use, and I wouldn't go as far as to say this has changed my life, but I can certainly say that this program has multiplied my work productivity. And there's no magic there. It's a simple Python program, yet tricky, that runs on the background, and all it does is it doesn't let you browse certain distracting websites such as Facebook or your email account during your working hours. And the program is tested to work on Windows, Mac and Linux. And the idea is that once you build this program, you pass to the program website links that you think are distracting. So you pass links as strings, and also the time that you're working on your computer. And the program will block these websites during these working hours. And in that way, you not only are much more productive, but this also reduces stress, as distraction is also known to cause stress. If you don't have any problem with distractions like I do, you probably won't need this program. So yeah, I don't want to go further with the usability aspect. So usability is one of the benefits that you get from this program. The second benefit is, of course, the Python part. Because this program is quite tricky to build, even though it's less than 30 lines of code. Here we're focusing on file manipulation and working with dates and times. And also the aspect of running a Python program as a process in the background, which is something we haven't yet learned in the course. And yeah, I'll do a quick demo now of the program. This is a program, so it's a Python script, a .py script, which later, if you want, you can attach to a graphical user interface if you want to give it to other people who don't know Python. And this Python script runs as soon as your computer starts. So now, this program, this Python script, is actually running as a process. As you can see, this is a program running, and you also see that this occupies very little space, actually. For instance, if you compare this with other processes, like Chrome, like the browser, you see that this is very, very insignificant, which means that you can have the program run continuously on your computer and it will not cause any problem. So the program is running, and if you try now to access Facebook, for instance, you'll get this. This site cannot be reached. Same for Hotmail. So I have a Hotmail account, so I have blocked that too. That means I have to go back to work, making up my mind that it's not the time to spend on such things right now. Maybe after 6 o'clock I can browse those websites if I want. And yeah, that's about it. I know you probably have not much idea on how to start with this, and I understand you, but I'll explain the architecture of the program in the next lecture, and then start building it. See you in the next lecture.